Hi friends, it's Music Monica and Music Katie. Let's start out by grabbing an instrument or just moving your body as we play a stop and go game with some vehicles. Are you ready to build a house with Music Katie? You're gonna need a hammer, a saw, a drill, and a paintbrush while we sing Build Myself a House.
I'm gonna get me a hammer. I'm gonna get me a hammer. I'm gonna get
Next, it's time to help Music Monica and the three little pigs build their houses big and strong so the wolf doesn't get them.
Once upon a time, there were lots of little pigs, and some of them thought they'd build themselves a straw house. So they built it, big and strong. They shut the door. Ka-chung! On the next day, some more little pigs decided to build themselves a stick house. So they built it big and strong. So the wolves wouldn't get them. And they shut the door. Ka-chunk! On the last day, the rest of the little pigs decided to build themselves a brick house. So they built it big and strong. So the wolves wouldn't get them. And they shut their big brick door. Ka-chung! In the meantime, the wolves were sleeping in the forest. Then the wolves woke up, and they stretched a big stretch. And they sniffed a big sniff. And they said, I smell pigs. So the wolves marched on over to the straw house, and they knock, knock, knocked on the door. And they said, little pigs, let me in. And the pig said, not by the hair on our chinny chin chins. Then we'll huff and we'll puff and we'll blow your house in. So they huffed and they puffed and they blew that house in. And the pigs ran over to their friends over at the stick house. So the wolves marched on over to the stick house, and they knock, knock, knocked on the door. And they said, little pigs, let us in. And the pig said, not by the hair on our chinny chin chins. Then we'll huff and we'll puff and we'll blow your house in. So they huffed and they puffed and they huffed and they puffed and they blew that house in. And the pigs ran over to their friends over at the brick house. So the wolves marched on over to the brick house, and they knock, knock, knocked on the door. And they said, little pigs, let us in. And the pig said, not by the hair on my chinny chin chin. Then we'll huff and we'll puff and we'll blow your house in. So they huffed and they puffed and they huffed and they puffed and they huffed and they puffed, but they couldn't blow that house in. So the wolves went over to the back of the house, and they climbed up the chimney. But the pigs heard them and put a pot of boiling water underneath the chimney. And the wolves landed in the water. And they burnt their bottoms and they went running back to the woods, where they cooled off in a lake. And they looked at each other and said, we didn't want to eat those pigs anyway.
Not me.
Let's go back and have a party.
Okay.
So they did.
Let's have some fun singing and dancing along with the Three Little Pigs Blues. Get out your guitars!
Once upon a time, there were three little pigs. One day, they were old enough to each have a house of their own. But their mother warned them to build their houses strong, so they would be safe from the big bad wolf. Now the first little pig was lazy, so when he built his house, this is what happened.
The first little pig built his house of straw. He ran inside when the wolf he saw.
Little pig, little pig, let me come in. Not by the hair of my chinny chin chin. So he huffed and he puffed and he huffed and he blew the house in.
Well, the first little pig ran off as fast as he could to hide from the big bad wolf. Now the second little pig didn't like to work either. So when he built his house, what do you think happened?
The second little pig built his house of sticks. The wolf came a-knocking just for kicks.
Little pig, little pig, let me go.
Second little pig ran off into the forest as fast as his little feet would go. Now the third little pig remembered what his mother told him, so he built his house strong and safe.
The third little pig built his house of brick. The wolf came along and ran inside quick.
Little pig, little pig, let me go.
Mr. Wolf, he was awful bad. He jumped on the house top. He was really mad.
Little pig, down the chimney I go. But the little pig had a boiling pot of water below. Ow! Look at him go.
It's time for a story with Music Katie. Look for the letters of the alphabet while she reads Goodnight, Goodnight, Construction Site, Cement Mixers, A, B, C. Then, tools become instruments during the Craftsman Music Experiment.
Hello, friends! Today, we are going to be reading a story all about the different things that we can find at a construction site. It is called Cement Mixers A, B, C. This is what the front of the book looks like. And this is what the back of the book looks like. Sherry Dusky Rinker is the author of the story. The author is the person who writes the book. Say that with me. The author is the person who writes the book. Ethan Long is the illustrator of the story. The illustrator is the person who draws the pictures. Say that with me. The illustrator is the person who draws the pictures. Now I think we're ready to begin. So put on your construction hat and let's go! Cement Mixers A, B, C by Sherry Dusky Rinker and Ethan Long. Cement Mixer starts to work and soon he begins to spin a little tune.
A is for all the words I'll find, construction words of every kind. From A to Z, just wait and see. But I wish my friend would sing with me. There's B for bulldozer and his blade. C is for concrete that I made. D is for dump truck on the road. E for excavator with his load. F is for the form I fill. G's for the gravel dump truck spills. And H is for the hazard lights that mark the sides of construction sites. Crane lifts an I-beam straight and strong. J is for jump as I bump along. Cement, water, sand, and gravel inside my big drum while I travel. I mix them up to make concrete, singing songs to keep the beat. K is for key. And L's for lights. Check my signals, left and right. All set now. M's for mix. Before N-O-P, now out it pours. Q, I'm one quick and clever guy. I pour it fast before it dries. R is for the road we've made. S for sun that starts to fade. Now teamwork, that's an awesome T. The teamwork est mixer, yep, that's me. Bulldozer tries to stay stern and proud, but hearing this makes him laugh out loud. You, I look up and see the moon. I know it will be nighttime soon. V, it's getting very dark. I'll stop my drum, it's time to park. And after a day of messy fun, W is for wash my drum. Look, bulldozer, we're all done. X marks the spot where I will rest and dream about what we'll do next. Y for yawn, it's time for bed. My singing's done, I'll sleep instead. But you didn't finish A, B, C. You forgot about the letter Z. Bulldozer chuckles at his friend. I guess that's Z, so that's the end. Wow! Listen carefully. Do you hear that? Those are the sounds of tools at a construction site. It almost sounds like music. If we listen closely, we will discover that there is music all around us. Let's now listen to a song that was made completely from construction tools. Wow, that was amazing how those tools made so many different sounds. What other sounds can you find around you?
What's next? It's time to help Music Monica read and count to Goodnight, Goodnight Construction Site, Excavators 1, 2, 3. Then we will finish with some more counting, stretching, and breathing with the yoga song.
Let's look at the front of the book to find the title and the authors. The title of my story is Goodnight, Goodnight Construction Site, Excavators 1, 2, 3. And this is written by Sherry Dusky Rinker and Ethan Long. Get ready to read and count.
Excavator arrives on site, ready to work and do it right. The team's counting on him today, so he'll get started right away. He revs right up and digs right in. There's one foundation to begin. With dump truck, it's a two-truck crew. He'll help excavator through and haul away what they don't need. This team has toughness, strength, and speed. Let's count the construction vehicles. Ready? One, two. Excavator lifts three loads of sand and digs four trenches in the land. How many trenches? One, two, three, four. Then excavator can begin to set some drainage piping in. He sets five pipes all in a row. Dump truck backfills and off they go. And one, two, three, four, and five. Excavator lifts and twists around and quickly clears six gravel mounds. Do you see the mounds or piles? Time to count. One, two, three, four, five, six. Excavator loves to dig, lift, run, but now he's having too much fun. Dump truck blows a few stern puffs. Get back on track now, friend, he huffs. Excavator jumps right into action, revs up the hill with super traction. He dumps seven scoops in the dump truck's bed, then rolls back down on sturdy tread. The two keep rocking all day long, lifting, hauling, quick and strong. They see eight boulders, huge and gray. One lifts them up, one hauls away. Let's count the boulders, or the big rocks. Can you find them? One, two, three, four, five, six. Do you see more? Seven, eight. Big excavator stops, digs, rolls, and in a flash he's dug nine holes. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Giant piles, 10 in all. All lined up, all neat and tall. And one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. The sun has set, the workday ends. Everyone counts on these great friends. At one awesome construction site, two trucks did their jobs just right. Their day is done. Goodbye. Good night. The end.
Can you stand up and make your body the shape of a star, so that your head is the very top of the star? Now stretch your fingers out as far as they'll go.
Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Take a deep breath.